For today's video, we will be discussing three topics, namely GIT or just-in-time production systems, backflash costing, and manufacturing cycle efficiency. Let's start. GIT is a manufacturing system whose goal is to optimize processes and procedure by continuously pursuing waste reduction. It is both a philosophy and a set of methods for manufacturing. Although it has no single or agreed-upon definition, GIT emphasizes waste reduction, total quality control, and devotion to the customer. What it is? It is a management philosophy and it follows pull system of demand. What it does? Number one, it attacks waste. Of course, waste does not add value to our firm. It exposes problems and bottlenecks in the processes and it achieves streamlined production. What it requires? In every aspect of the GIT system, it requires employee participation. Industrial engineering basics are also put into place. Continuing improvement, total quality control, and small lot sizes. The assumption here is that we have a stable environment. So as you can see, when we implement just-in-time production systems, we reduce the inventory. So we will order from our suppliers from the time that it will be put into production. As much as possible, we want to reduce or eliminate the waste in the company so that we can contribute to the increase of our profit. Remember, our target is to have a maximum profit for the business. When we implement GIT production systems, we have what we call the Kanban. We order from our producer or supplier once the Kanban box has been emptied. We need to coordinate with our suppliers when will be the delivery of our goods so that our Kanban box will be refilled. So we have the Kanban signal in order for us to monitor what are the specific materials or items that needs to be refilled from our suppliers. In here, we do not maintain inventory. That's why we call it just in time. So upon the arrival of our goods, we will use it in our production. There is a less cost of carrying the inventory in our warehouse, and there's also less cost for our spoilage. An example in your monitor is a Kanban board wherein you will classify what items are going to be done, what items are in backlog, what items are now being processed, which is our ongoing, and what are the items used in order to finish our goods. So there's a monitoring. What are the advantages and disadvantages of using GIT? The advantages are, number one, less space required for stock. It enables us to respond quickly to changes in demand. Closer relationship with suppliers is needed, and capital can be used for other priorities as opposed to being tied up in stocks. On the other hand, the limitations of GIT are production may be stopped if supplies are delayed, specifically if there is a 4327 caused by fire, typhoon, or other calamities. Next, sales may be lost if not meeting customer demands. Remember that in business, it is better to have surplus instead of shortages, because if you will have shortages and your customers would like to order from you and you cannot serve them, then you will have an opportunity loss. Next, we have increased ordering and administrative costs. Of course, because we don't have any carrying costs, so there is a probability that your ordering cost will increase, which is your shipping. And lastly, depending on the efficiency of the supplier, so you need to scan, you need to screen those suppliers who can fulfill your needs, and also you need to have a close relationship with them. Next topic would be backflash costing. It is a product costing technique in which the costing process is delayed until the final production of goods and services. Therefore, there is no requirement of maintaining work in progress account. You do not use, we use raw and in process. It is a combination of raw materials and work in process because you will put them in your books once production is done. So during production, there are no journal entries required for you in recording the costing, and only one journal entry is recorded at the end of production process using this technique. What are the benefits of backflash costing? It simplifies costing operation and accounting tasks because you will only record it in the books once. Next, relatively easy to verify materials used. Post-production issuance is simple, easier to track the inventory, and it keeps check on reverse issuance of materials. What are the drawbacks or limitations? Number one, it is not in line with GAAP and difficult to use. The assignment of standard costs at the end may result in variances in actual costs. We will tackle standard costing in a different video. Next, does not record work in progress inventory, so it means it is difficult to track if you do not have any records on your books, and it depends on the accuracy of information. Reliability of your records is somehow questioned if you use backflash costing. Let's go to manufacturing cycle efficiency, or MCE. We will discuss the five types of time. We have the acronym WPIMQ. W stands for wait time. It is the time from the arrival of your goods from your suppliers. Next, we have P, or process time, the time that you will convert raw materials into finished goods. I, inspection time. You need to know the conformance of your goods from the specifications. M, or move time. It is the time that you will transfer the goods from your warehouse going to your store. And lastly, we have the Q, or the queue time. It is the time that you will transfer the goods from your store going to your customers. If we will add wait time, process time, inspection time, move time, and queue time, we call it your delivery cycle time. While if we will only add process time, inspection time, move time, and queue time, we call it your throughput time, or manufacturing cycle time. In relation to the five types of time, we will discuss the two types of activities, namely value-adding time and non-value-adding time. When you say value-adding time, it is meaningful to the customer or changes the product or service in a meaningful way. It adds importance or worth to the product. And when we say non-value-added time, or waste, it consumes resources but does not add value. Let us classify your time. Under value-added activities, you only have process time. The rest, wait time, inspection time, move time, and queue time, are non-value added activities. If we will compute our manufacturing cycle efficiency ratio, or MCE, the formula would be value added time over manufacturing cycle time. So if we will substitute our different types of time here, value added time is our process time, while our manufacturing cycle time are process plus inspection plus move plus queue time. What does manufacturing cycle efficiency ratio gives us? It measures how efficiently products are being produced. We need to know the ratio of the value added time in the total time that we consume in production. Now, to end our video, I will leave you a quotation from William Penn, which states, "Time is what we want most, but what we use worst." So I hope you learned something from this video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share in order for us to reach more accounting students and learn about management accounting. Good day, guys!